Now let's bring in the Attorney General of Kano State, Ibrahim Mukhtar, for more on this development. Thank you for joining us on TVC News at 9. Well, the dethronement and banishment of the former Emir of Kano has now raised some legal and constitutional issues. For the ousted Emir's legal team, it's an issue of old tradition and colonial practice which has no basis under the Nigerian Constitution. And they are indeed baffled that political leaders will now resort to what they call an archaic practice in present-day Nigeria. How exactly do you react to this?
My reaction is simple. It has been a practice in northern Nigeria when an emir is removed from power. He normally is not allowed to stay within that particular jurisdiction, but he should be taken out of that jurisdiction. And the practice started during the colonial period, and it remains the practice. If you could remember, the Sultan, Dasuki, was removed by government, the then government. He was taken to Kaduna for some time. Jokolo, Mustapha Jokolo, Emir of Gwandu, was also taken out of Gwandu to another place for some time. But my understanding is that is for security purpose, the security of the person, the security of the people, that is maintenance of peace, of that there shouldn't be any dispute, any quarrel involving the supporters of the two emirs within the same area of jurisdiction. I think that is the rationale for such a practice. But I don't understand it amounts to detention, actually. But I think a security person would do better, because they are the one responsible. They are the one to assess the situation and to give the reason why they are taking away such a person from the locality where he resides to another locality.
I get your point precisely, Attorney General. You mentioned earlier about the case of the Emir of Ganduje. Are you aware that reference is now being made to a judicial precedence in that regards, precisely to the case of the Attorney General of Kebbi State versus His Royal Highness Alhaji Al-Mustapha Jokolo, where the Court of Appeal pronounces dethronement and banishment illegal, unconstitutional, and a gross violation of the Emir's right?
Yeah. You know, in law, when it comes to judicial pronouncements, it depends on the facts and circumstances of each case. So it depends on the facts in the case of Jokolo and the facts in the case of Emir of Kano, Sanusi. The comparison between these two cases and the report from the security report by the security people, the police and the DSS. It is that comparison that will solve the problem, and until we get the report why he's been taken, then we rely on that particular authority. But I cannot distinguish the two cases now at hand.
You know, another question that has risen now is, how exactly do you banish someone to another state not under the constitutional control of the Kano State government?
You know, I told you it is not the directive of Kano State government. It is not a decision of Kano State government. The decision by Kano State government is just to remove the emir. But all these actions are purely based on security reasons. So the justification of such a decision will better be given by the security personnel.
Many people have termed this...
They will have a reason for that.
Attorney General, many people have termed this a lifetime banishment. Is that what it is?
No. No, I don't think so. To the best of my knowledge, there is no emir ever in northern Nigeria, or wherever, to the best of my knowledge, who is banished for life.
Absolutely. So how long will he stay in Nasarawa State?
My understanding is probably for some time to make sure that everything is okay, the security situation is okay, and maybe probably the possibility of having any dispute, any problem, any security issue within the state. If there is such a report, I believe, from my analysis and understanding, it will be over and he will continue with his normal activities and life. And even over there, I don't think that it amounts to imprisonment, because I think he's free to meet with his people and his family, actually. But I don't think it is imprisonment, from my understanding and my assessment, even though I was not there, actually.
Attorney General Kano State, Ibrahim Mukhtar, thank you for talking to us on TVC News.